Let's go ahead and take a look at what's happening right now. You can see the storms that went through or are going through right now. Earlier, we had some severe weather up towards the north, Edinburgh, over towards Union City, Waterford. They had the possibility of a tornado that touched down. It was reported by law enforcement as well as trained spotters up there. Of course, we'll have to wait till the National Weather Service to do a storm survey tomorrow to get the official word on whether or not that was a tornado or not. Here's what's happening right now just north of Franklin. We saw some rain and lightning that is moving through the area. That will continue to push off towards the east. So down south in Pittsburgh, we're not going to have to worry about precipitation for tonight. It is pretty mild, 71 degrees currently with a dew point of 60 degrees. So a little bit on the humid side with winds out of the south at 6 miles per hour. Warm enough today, 80 degrees, 6 above the average of 74 and 15 off the record of 95 set back in 1881. Here are your high temperatures around the region. A number of locations at 80, including West Mifflin, Pittsburgh, and Wheeling. A little further to the west, it got a little warmer. 83 Parkersburg, 83 in Zanesville. That warmer air is going to overspread the area as we head into tomorrow. Temperatures right now still in the low 70s, very mild out there this evening. And as we head over the next couple of days, it is going to stay downright hot. Take a look at this. Tomorrow we're shooting for high temperature 86. Then we take it up to 88 on both Thursday and Friday, 85 on Saturday. So Thursday and Friday, some locations could be hitting 90 degrees. And here's what's happening, the setup for the warm air. We have low pressure to our west, a warm front that has moved through, and that is going to keep us in this warm sector as we head through the week. And that's just going to continue to pump up that warm air into the region. So we will have warm air and also will give us a chance of seeing some storms to the north of us again tomorrow along the I-80 corridor. Could have a chance for some strong thunderstorms moving through that area. You'll see it here. Here's 8 o'clock in the morning on Wednesday on Futurecast. Everybody is in mostly clear to partly cloudy skies. Then as we head into the afternoon, you can see where we have that front located or very close to it. We have the potential for showers to break out as well as some thunderstorms in this area. Could make it as far south as northern Butler County, Armstrong County, Indiana County, but most of us will be staying dry tomorrow. And then we take it into Thursday, mostly clear skies, and again, most of us will be staying dry on Thursday. So we take it into tomorrow morning, looking for a low temperature of 63 degrees, partly cloudy, with a southwest breeze 10 to 15 miles per hour, and then a high tomorrow 86 degrees, partly cloudy. And again, we're looking for that rain to stay mainly north of Pittsburgh, up around Interstate 80. Temperatures in your town, here's what we're looking at. Somerset 84, Indiana 83, Uniontown, you'll see a high of 86 degrees. For Butler, 84 degrees, Beaver 85, Newcastle 84, and Clarion 83 degrees. Down south in Morgantown, you'll already be pushing the 90-degree mark tomorrow with a high of 88 degrees. Wheeling, 87. Also 87 in Brownsville and Washington, 86. And looking for a high in Wexford, mid-80s, 85 degrees. Penn Hills, 86. 87 for South Hills and Moon, 86 degrees. So as we go through the next 4 days, it is going to be very warm, especially Thursday and Friday. Mostly sunny skies with those temperatures pushing the 90-degree mark. Then Saturday, we're going to have a cold front that's going to be approaching. That's going to give us a chance for some showers on Saturday, a high of 85, and then we take it to Sunday, an even better chance for rain on Sunday. And you see how the temperatures trend down as we head through the week and into next week. Sunday, rain showers, cloudy skies, 80 degrees, and then we drop it into the 70s as we head into next week.